What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome back to another episode of Go GTS Live, Season 2, Episode 5. I'm pleased to be joined tonight by the asset, James Gale, out of Southern California. What's up, James?
Not much, Rob. I'm doing well. How are you doing?
If I'm any better, I'd be twins. I appreciate you filling in for Ivan. Really? He's sure. MIA. He had a prearranged event. We knew he was going to be off tonight. But, so we're going to make up for some lost time and got a really good show for you guys planned tonight to give you an idea of what we've got going on. We're going to talk a little World Baseball Classic, find out if anybody out there cares, and share some...
I care.
Okay, cool. Share some insight we received from Tops this week. We're going to take a look at collecting the top 10 MLB fantasy baseball prospects of 2017. After a couple of solid weeks of new releases, next week explodes with even a bigger schedule of new releases. So we'll queue up a brand new segment of Hot in the Shop. We've got a pre-recorded interview I had the opportunity to do yesterday with center of the Pittsburgh Steelers, Valerian Ume Izuake. He was Panini America's NFLPA's extern. He wrapped up a three-week program with the company this week, and we had an opportunity to talk with him about that. And he actually was highly involved in this year's Father's Day promotion, and we'll find out more about that in video interview about halfway through the program. We'll take a look at the new McFarlane EA Sports Madden NFL 18 Ultimate Team Series number 1. That's a mouthful. Who made the roster and who didn't. And then we've got some box breaks. As promised, we've got Donruss NASCAR Racing, and we'll take a look at Plates and Patches NFL Football. So,
it's a big show.
Big show. Really big show. Really big.
I don't get that reference.
Come on. Yeah, you do.
Ed Sullivan. From something.
Come on.
Television? Oh, sure. They named a theater after him.
There you go. All right, well, to kick things off, we had a little bit of news come in from Tops this week. Mm. And interestingly enough, it just happens to coincide with the World Baseball Classic. And even though Team USA is missing some, I would say, pretty key players, they've still got a pretty robust roster all in all. And it seems that people have been, you know, really happy with the games, the tournament overall. It's kind of like
Israel.
How about
they're playing well?
Yeah, they're 3-0 or 4-0 now.
Yeah,
and basically, you know, we've seen some of their insert and subsets in products in the past, but Topps is going to up the ante this year. Seeing as this event, this tournament, kind of, you know, really serves as the precursor to MLB's opening day, Topps said, well, you know, let's do something special for the occasion. So sure enough, leave it to Topps to include in one of the most eclectic trading card sets in all of the hobby, Allen and Ginter, is going to have game-used jersey cards of Topps, excuse me, of top World Baseball Classic players.
That's exciting.
Yeah, so if you're into the World Baseball Classic, like, especially, you know, if guys you PC are on one of the squads, that'll be some cool cards to chase. There's going to be two exclusive relics with game-used jerseys only found in Topps, Allen, and Ginter hobby boxes. Framed mini relics with 10 players, checklist still to be revealed. Each of those is going to be numbered to just 10. And then full-size relics featuring 30 international superstars numbered to 99 or fewer.
Okay. So they're varying up the relic sizes. You're going to get the plain little ones, yep, like they like to do, the framed minis.
Yep.
But then they'll also have larger ones.
Like the full-size card.
Yep. Great.
And kind of they added this at the end of the blog post or PR statement they sent out saying, World Baseball Classic relic cards will also appear in Topps Museum Baseball and Topps Dynasty as well. But we have zero information as to what that will entail. So we're just in a wait and see mode on that. So
Okay.
if you are a World Baseball Classic fan and needed any additional reason to pick up a box of Allen and Ginter, this might be something right up your alley. Allen and Ginter hit shops in late July, if I remember correctly.
Oh, nice. Usually, yeah, it's late
Right
July,
before
August
the
sometime.
National.
One of my favorite sets every year.
It's fun.
So that's fun that they're in court. It's a fun rip. It really is.
It is.
And
Interestingly enough, I'll tell you, I have opened a box of Allen and Ginter and Heritage probably every year for the past, gosh, I don't know, 10, 11, 12 years, maybe longer. I have yet to pull a boom out of either of those products. I see all this amazing stuff come out, and those are two that I just can't get the monkey off my back. But
Yeah.
I actually got a box of Heritage for this year, and so stay tuned for a flash break probably
Oh boy.
this weekend.
That's exciting.
And
I tell you though, I have one big boom out of Allen and Ginter. 2 years ago, I got a Craig Biggio booklet
oh,
with
nice.
a bat and an autograph to 10.
A booklet,
So that was,
no
I got
doubt.
a one big Ginter hit. That was mine. And so
So they come like
yeah,
every
it's a fun
10
set.
years.
Yeah, right. Exactly. I had the only one. Well, no, I've had some fun ones, but yeah, it's a great set. I'm excited for this year. Excited to see what they do with the World Baseball Classic. They had that Topps Tribute WBC.
Yep.
But other than that, it's been I think there were some relics and triple threads 1 year too.
Yeah, some inserts here and there, but it seems like they're making a bigger push on that, so.
I really like the logos. All the logos for the WBC teams are cool.
I agree.
So hopefully we'll get some good patch cards. We'll see those pop out once it releases in late July, early August.
Yep. And I like the timing of the event too. It coming right before opening day, I think it gets
Yeah.
the competitive juices for the guys going more than just, squad games out in the desert.
Sure, we're in Florida. My only concern is throwing those high leverage innings for a pitcher that early in the season. There's always the injury risk, and as a fantasy baseball player,
I hear you.
which is our next
How
topic,
about
right?
that? Look at you,
Yeah.
Mr. Segway.
But as a fantasy baseball player, I worry about these WBC. But I do like you said, a little extra competition, right, to get going. I think that's nice.
Yeah.
But if I recall, some early games, although probably not the ones that would have teams, the way they do it with the teams is you can shuffle players back and forth between teams, so your roster's really big, and not all the players on the Team USA roster, like I have it up here, and it's huge.
Yeah, it is huge, so.
But they go between their spring training camp and the WBC games. And so, like some players, I'm just looking through the list right now, say Andrew McCutcheon. Although I haven't watched any games yet, so I don't know if this is true. But say Andrew McCutcheon isn't playing in this round of WBC games, but if they make it to that final round, then he'll play.
Exactly. Talking about injury bugs and stuff, it's why I'm glad the NHL isn't going to go to the Winter Olympics, at least in the near future. Especially with it being right in the middle of the season, and those extra
Yeah.
games take a toll. And I just,
Definitely.
I mean, my team's motto is one goal, and you throw the Olympics into that really kind of just puts a monkey wrench in the whole one goal plan, if you ask me. So fine by me.
Yeah.
But yeah, you teased it, and let's dive
Yeah.
into it here. I saw an article on MLB, and they were talking about the top 10 fantasy baseball prospects. I always want to say products for 2017. I said, you know what? Let's talk a little bit about collecting these guys. And most of the names are going to be familiar to you, but some may not. But starting off the top of the list, 1 through 5 here, we'll count down. We don't have to do it in reverse order because I think there's no super mega surprises. But number one out of the Boston Red Sox, Andrew Benintendi. This guy's been on prospects radar, prospecting radar for years, and his key card.
7th overall pick.
Yeah, absolutely. 7th overall in 2015. So as would be expected, he's got a Chrome Draft Picks autograph card in 2015 Bowman Draft. He's also got an auto in that year's Bowman's Best. I'm a big fan of the Bowman's Best brand, so the fact that he's got autos in there is cool. And then his, to throw, you know, confusion into everything, his officially licensed and logoed MLB rookie card will be in 2017 Topps products. So if you're just looking for his regular standard official plain base RC, he's in Topps Series 1 now. But you'd be amazed. Even those cards, you know, when they get graded in higher grades, still trade for, you know, decent money, more than you would expect from a common base card. Who we got number two on the list, James?
We have Dansby Swanson.
Swanson.
Originally drafted 1st overall by the Diamondbacks, but he was traded to the Atlanta Braves in the Shelby Miller trade.
Yeah, he was.
Ender Inciarte was part of that trade, and some other prospects. But Dansby Swanson, he is officially a rookie this year.
Officially a rookie this year. Mm-hmm. Made his MLB debut August 17th of last year, so past the official designation dates. Nice stats, though. 129 at-bats, 3 home runs, 17 ribbies. And look at that, 302 batting average.
He was drafted in my fantasy league this draft this last weekend. So he is definitely on the radar. He projects to be more of a kind of a average speed guy, not necessarily going to give you 30 home runs, but maybe 15.
Yeah.
Hitting atop that Braves lineup. The Braves are in a new stadium this year. They have they spent a little money this offseason. They're gonna be a fun little team.
Yeah.
They fleeced Arizona getting Dansby Swanson in that trade.
Absolutely they did.
Now these are your guys coming up next, right?
Yeah, one thing I wanted to point out though, for those who prefer to collect the autograph of the player in their preferred jersey for your team. So if you want his true early high value prospect auto, that's in 2015 Bowman draft. But in 2016 he's gonna Bowman Chrome Prospects, he's in his Braves uniform. So, and you can check out secondary market pricing for all these guys we talked about on the blog. Yeah, I was a little bit surprised when my White Sox acquired Yoan Moncada. The jury's still very much out on this kid. If you ask me, I mean, he's been highly touted for a few years now. Chrome Prospect autograph in 2016, Bowman Chrome, an autograph in 2016, Bowman's Best, official RC this year. He only hit .211 in 19 at-bats, but then again, it is only 19 at-bats. So we'll have to wait and see. This kid's a work in progress. But he's going to have every opportunity to come out of spring training on the roster.
Good. I'm excited. You know what? Speaking of fantasy baseball, I drafted him in my keeper auction. So I have him for $2. So if he has a good... Is he starting the season with the team? I know he's still...
He's going to be given every opportunity. I think they want him to, so...
They're full rebuild then.
Oh, total.
Wonderful. Good. Let him play. That's fun. I like it. I mean, I lived in Milwaukee for 10 years, and I saw the Brewers make 2 playoff runs, and I saw them tear it down and rebuild. So I like watching teams rebuild.
It's long overdue for the south side of Chicago.
Yeah. Well, you have a World Series in 2005.
Yeah.
So that's
pretty good. I won't complain about that. Yeah. We're still
Our next player... he plays for the Pittsburgh Pirates, a team that was always rebuilding until they got good recently, although they just can't get past that first round of the playoffs. Josh Bell, Pittsburgh Pirates, first base outfielder. He was drafted in the second round of the 2011 draft, 61st overall. He made his MLB debut last year, July 8th. Although I see here the picture of his officially branded RC rookie card is in this year's set. It wasn't in an update set.
Correct.
And so, but through 128 major league at-bats, he is hitting .273, three home runs, 19 runs batted in.
Those are solid numbers.
He went in this draft. Yeah. No, and they like him a lot. They're going to, I believe he has the first base job in Pittsburgh. So he's a guy that's going to get a lot of playing time. And boy, I'm looking at his Bowman Chrome from what year? 2012?
2012, yeah.
That's a sharp looking autograph on that. That's a nice looking card.
Yeah, it is.
I like it.
I mean, it's just amazing to me. You know, how long it does take some guys to get there. You know, this guy, mm-hmm. I mean, if you went in early back in 2012 and stocked up on this guy, you could be looking at a major windfall if you're a prospector.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting stuff. When I saw this name on the list, I owe Leaf Trading Cards an apology.
Oh, yes. I remember this story.
Manuel Margot of the San Diego Padres, an international free agent, debuted September 21st of last year. Small sample size at the plate, 37 at-bats, three ribbies, hit .243. He's got a Chrome Prospect auto in 2014 Bowman Chrome, and then also an auto in Bowman's Best the following year, 2015.
So we should look for a Series 2.
Yeah, I'm thinking a Series 2.
Branded rookie card. Now, they were talking about him on SiriusXM Fantasy Radio the other day while I was in the car. And they said, Manny Margot hits lefties. So if you're a DFS player like I am, play daily fantasy sports, think about Manny Margot out there in San Diego. He crushes lefties. And he's going to get all the opportunities to play.
Can't beat that.
We got another Padre next up, Hunter Renfroe. He can hit home runs. Look up Hunter Renfroe home runs from last year. He hit some upper deckers out of that San Diego park where they have the big brick building out there in left. I can't remember what it's called. Somebody hopefully can.
Is that still called Petco?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. But we got Hunter Renfroe. He was drafted 13th overall in the 2013th draft, first round. Made his debut last year, September 21st, 2016. So he didn't get that. He only got 35 at-bats. He hit four home runs, though. 14. Drove in 14 runs. Hit .371.
371.
35 at-bats, though. But still, he's exciting. He played against the Dodgers. I remember the Dodgers watching him crush Maeda. Can't remember who he hit it off of. But, yeah, he has a lot of raw power. If you like home runs, he is worthy of a late-round pick in your fantasy draft. I have him in a fantasy league. I have a lot of these players on fantasy teams. So this
you're ahead of the curve.
Yeah.
Look how much his autograph has changed in 4 years.
Yeah, wow. Looking at that, what is that? That's that 13 set, yeah. And then, well, he might have had to shorten it for that sticker on the second one.
I don't know. It's the same still. Space.
Yeah, true.
Don't make excuse.
he kept it on sticker.
Oh, of course. We teed up the order so that I get to pronounce Ulieski.
I got it.
Shoot.
Ulieski Gria.
Thank you. Of the Houston Astros, another international free agent who made his debut in August 21st of last year. A much larger sample size, 130 at-bats, three home runs, 15 RBIs, .262. It's going to make a nice compliment to Carlos Correa down there. Astros are in a rebuilding phase as well, and they're going to let the young kids play too. Look for a autograph of him in 2016 Bowman's Best, and then his super action shot RC in 2017 Topps Series 1.
Another player I have on a fantasy team. He's got the first base job. Because I think Bregman's their third baseman. And so I think he's got their first base job to start the season. And they liked him. He's a Cuban prospect, so
That's always a good thing, usually.
you're either Yasiel Puig or you're Yoenis Cespedes or you're another Cuban prospect,
Jose
Jose
Abreu,
Abreu. Pretty good ones. Or there's the flameouts, like who was the guy for the Red Sox? And he had a little bit of speed, Joe. Listening for you.
He has a name.
Oh boy, I don't know, but while we're thinking about him, we are on to Tyler Glasnow,
The only pitcher
Pittsburgh
on the
Pirates.
list.
He is the only pitcher on the list. But we got some sharp looking cards. This blog entry is great. Look for it on Twitter. I'll schedule a few for tomorrow. With a fun little GIF I made counting them down.
Cool.
Tyler Glasnow was drafted in the fifth round of the 2011 draft. Is he the lowest rated draft, lowest drafted draft pick on this list too?
150
That's fun.
second. That's pretty low.
Well, it's a Rusney Castillo. Thank you, Joe. He kind of flamed out. He's from Cuba, I believe. But anyway, 100, I mean, 152nd overall. Not, I mean, the fifth round. There's a lot of rounds in the MLB draft. It takes a while. But he made his debut last year on July 7th. To this date, he has 23 major league innings pitched, and he has struck out more than a batter per inning. He has
That's
24 of them.
always a good
But,
sign.
and it's a good sign from a prospect. We don't really look at the, I mean, we got the numbers here, 4.24 ERA, 1.50 WHIP. But again, that's, 23 innings. If you show that you can get major league batters to swing and miss, you can have a nice long career. I know he's struggling a little bit in spring training, although I have a friend who drafted him and is excited for about his long-term prospects. He is worth a late round pick in your fantasy league.
He's also one of the Chrome rookie autographs in the silver pack promotion from Topps that's going
Oh.
on. So he's got a 1987 Chrome card with the autograph and those bonus packs. Those have been selling for big money. All of these players have links to their secondary market pricing as well for you to look at. Number nine on the list, Aaron Judge, New York Yankees,
Yeah.
former first rounder from 2013, 32nd overall. He came up last year, August 13th, 2016. 84 at bats, four home runs, 10 ribbies, a dreadful batting average of 179. He's going to, he's a work in progress too, but they've got high hopes for this kid. They're not going to give up on him anytime soon.
And is RC okay? There it is RC in this year. And hey, four home runs though, in only 84 at bats for a young guy like that. You'll take it. They're giving him all the opportunities. They're not trying to win anytime soon. We have our final player of Los Angeles Dodgers, Cody Bellinger, drafted in the fourth round of the 2013 draft, 124th overall. I'll tell you about Cody Bellinger because I saw him at the Arizona Fall League Prospects game this last
Oh,
year, this
cool.
last fall in November. He hit a moonshot down the right field line. He is a great prospect. The only thing blocking him is a guy named Adrian Gonzalez,
Yeah, they have
who,
depth issues, right?
yep, but he is getting work in the outfield right now. I know, and I mean, if the bat plays at the major league level and they can't afford, well, they can afford to keep him down in AAA, I believe, but
Yeah, obviously being on the list, they don't want to. I mean, he
yeah.
hasn't even made his major league debut, but it sounds like they're going to give him every opportunity to make the club out of camp, huh?
Sure. And a lot of ways the Dodgers can go. They're a very interesting team in terms of the assets that they have and what they're trying to do. They got to beat the Cubs though. So all we have right here is the 2013 Bowman Chrome Prospect Auto. I think when I was looking up the GIF, I saw that he has a few more things out there, or does he not?
He does, but this is as of right now, since he doesn't have an officially licensed rookie card, this is the big one. I could have gone much deeper. It's not that when I put key cards down, so
Yeah.
Panini Leaf, don't take any offense. You know,
there were some leaves in the Moncadas, though.
I had to put some criteria in some capacity. And I know here's I go through an arduous algorithm to calculate the key cards. This is what I do.
Okay.
I type in the player's name in eBay. Yep. I hit search. I click advanced. I click sold by, and I click sort by highest price to lowest. And whatever's in the first page, those are the ones that I consider their key cards, because obviously that's what collectors consider their key cards. So
I'd be 100% with you. That's how you do it.
But they lots of affordable options from Leaf and Panini as well. Panini Elite Extra Edition, Prism, Leaf Metal Draft, Trinity, great products. And most of these
Leaf
guys
has an exclusive with somebody. I thought they had an exclusive with Moncada for a second, didn't they?
They were the first one to actually get him on card in anything.
That's it. Yeah. That's it. Okay. Yep. And I believe he's in that blog entry. I believe I did include that in the gift, I recall. Okay, great.
That is a look at your top 10 MLB fantasy baseball prospects for 2017 and a look at their key cards. As the asset said, look for a post on that. You can go to gogts.net or click on the link in the GIF that will be floating around on Facebook and Twitter.
Yep.
Very cool.
That was fun. Fantasy baseball is the best. Better than football.
Well, then you're going to be really excited because in a couple weeks, I have arranged to get our hands on a box of Honus Bonus Fantasy Baseball.
Honus Bonus.
We're going to open some packs and we're going to give, instead of opening the whole box, we're going to open some packs and we're going to give some packs unopened away to some people to get them into the hands of collectors right away, to get them on the site and start play. So we'll get to check that out firsthand in a couple of weeks.
Great. I'm excited.
All right. It is now time to shift gears to one of my favorite subjects always of the night. And that's what's coming out next week in a little ditty we like to call Hot in the Shop, a look ahead at next week's new releases. And as usual, James, I'll just I'll kick this off and we'll just alternate if that's good with you.
Perfectly fine.
All righty. First up, the first product of the year from our friends at Onyx. Lance Fisher and the guys have been busy putting together Onyx Preferred Players Collection. This is a autographed baseball in every box product. Each ball comes in a custom box and display cube with an Onyx authenticated certificate of authenticity. Find baseballs from superstars, top prospects, and future stars. Limited to just 50 total cases with 12 boxes a case. So you can do the math. This is limited. Look for superstars like Clayton Kershaw, Mike Trout, Bryce Harper, and more. Future stars, a couple guys we just talked about, Aaron Judge, Alex Bregman, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Oh, did I mention that there's full-sized game-used items or redemptions, therefore, randomly inserted for guys like Nick Gordon, Victor Robles, Gary Sanchez, and Lewis Brinson. Check out the complete checklist on GoGTS.net, and that releases next Monday.
Next Monday. Well, next Wednesday, you can look forward to a classic release that's been out for, gosh, I guess I don't know how many years, but
a long time,
I got
now, right?
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. 2017 Topps opening day baseball cards. If you don't know what it is by now, it's 36 insert cards in every box. It is a customer-friendly price point.
Yes.
There's the dialogue. It's a fun little set, though, because they have a lot of fun with these insert sets. It's a 200-card base set, so easily collectible. It's not too overwhelming. We got parallel editions. We got opening day editions numbered to 2017. There's also a one-of-one edition. There's also printing plates. There's variations, image variations that capture fun, candid moments from the 2016 MLB season. One thing I love about certain sets is the pictures they get and the image variations. They're a lot of fun. I like to collect image variations of my favorite players.
Who doesn't?
I really like Yu Darvish. I have an image variation of him throwing with his left hand
Oh,
because I am left-handed,
cool.
and that is fun. So, but that's not from opening day. Sorry. We're talking about opening day right now. 36 insert cards, every box. Superstar Celebration. So cool. Pictures of celebrations. That's awesome. Like Edwin Encarnacion, where he does this. He's got the parrot. Right?
Yep.
Remember
And
that?
there's also like stuff in there like ballpark food this year as an insert set.
Yes, I saw that. They have the nachos from Miller Park. Cracknell was talking about that. Yeah. I think that's great. They've got the mascot cards. Do they have the autographs this year? I know one year they did
I don't know
mascot
if there's
autographs.
mascot autographs, but there are, stadium signature cards of MLB
Opening day
players.
stars.
I don't know about the mascots, though.
Speaking of Miller Park and the Brewers bobbleheads, Brewers are one of the best teams when it comes to stadium giveaways, and so they'll hopefully have a few cool ones in the bobblehead insert set. Yep, there's his Credible Eats national anthem. Stadium signatures, whether you get to the stadium earlier, hang out after the game, nothing beats an autograph from an MLB player. So that's an autograph.
Yep.
There are autographs in this set and relics. It's just they're not guaranteed one per box, correct?
Correct.
But they're out there. I see people pulling red autographs, maybe not red,
Yeah,
but
so
rare
when you
autographs
pull
out of
one,
heritage
it's
retail. So
cool because it's not expected.
yeah, exactly.
Like kind of how it
That's
used to
fun.
be back in the day, as they say.
Yes. When we were kids.
We got more baseball. 2017 Panini Stars and Stripes celebrate Team USA. With five autographed or memorabilia cards, five parallels, and 30 base cards in every box. On-card signatures from 49 players, including top draft picks, excuse me, top prospects, draft picks, future draft picks, and alumni. Everybody loves former Team USA alumni. Limited parallels signed in black, red, and green ink, which is cool. Collegiate national team signatures, an exclusive 44 card set signed on card. The alumni signatures of prestigious former Team USA members are also signed on card. Love it. Stars and Stripes signatures, 100
Look at
card autograph insert set featuring baseball collegiate and 18 under national team alumni. Parallels including prime memorabilia buttons and laundry tags. Also find jumbo swatch silhouette signatures. That's a 200 card autograph set. Holy cow. More on
Ooh.
card autographs with 13 pairings and dual autographs, including parallels in red and green ink. And then quad materials featuring four players and four swatches, prime versions numbered at 25 or less. If you're a base collector, you're going to have need a few boxes of this because there's a 100 card base set. You get 30 base cards in the box. And the design of these cards this year is really sharp. And as you mentioned, talking about chasing, guys you collect, I like getting, Frank Thomas is someone I would chase in this product
Yeah,
because I'm a White
I love
Sox
what
guy.
Panini does with
Yeah.
USA Baseball.
Yep.
Yeah, they have a lot of fun stuff.
Quite a coup for them. So that releases also next Wednesday, the 15th. Stars and Stripes baseball from Panini.
So next Friday, St. Patrick's Day, you can get 2016-17 Panini Select NBA Basketball. It delivers three autographed or memorabilia cards, plus 12 prism parallels in every box. Select has been around for a while.
Shiny.
It is shiny. Now, I don't know if they've done this the past few years, but what they have a 300 card tiered base set. Did they do this previous years, or is this the first year doing this?
I know they've done
Do you
it in
remember?
another. I think this has been in select before, yes.
Okay. So 1 through 100 in the base set is called the concourse level. Those are obviously the easiest to pull. Then the next one's 101 to 200. That's premier level, a little bit harder. Then we got courtside, 201 to 300 in the set. I do not see any odds or anything like that. It's one of the short prints. We have a checklist available don't we?
We will.
I feel like I scheduled a tweet with one. Maybe not.
We actually, it went live today, actually. I will, I'll have it up tomorrow. I was inundated with a big project today. I couldn't get it up, but I promise I will tomorrow.
If you follow us on Twitter, you will see it, because I am the one who schedules those, and I'll make sure it comes out periodically throughout the day, all weekend. Three autograph or memorabilia cards in every box. We've got veterans. We've got rookies. Rookie signatures are on card. So I know the past few years collecting my favorite players from the Timberwolves has been expensive because they have been on card autographs. I actually don't have them because they are expensive, but that's okay. We have die cut autographs with unique card stocks, unique designs, die cut shapes. In-flight signatures.
I like those.
No, I had the picture up, and yeah, I liked those too. Yeah, there it is. It's that landscape view. There he is, Blake Griffin.
Yep.
That's a sharp-looking card, and boy, that... who was that? That's an Isaiah Thomas. Oh, boy. Poor... salt in the wound. Isaiah Thomas, Kings patch. I wish they still had him. Base set... Prism Parallels.
Chase the Rainbow.
You're going to have rainbows. We got tie-dyes. We got orange. We got gold to 10. Gold to 10. Black to 101. Tie-dye to 25. That's select. NBA basketball. Next Friday. St. Paddy's Day. And I believe the NCAA tournament or something, right?
Yeah, I think it's that time of year. A little March Madness. Another basketball product debuts next week as well in the form of Super Break Buyback. Edition basketball. This is a zero memorabilia product, zero redemptions, all cards, all premium cards, top Hall of Famers, modern superstars, MVPs, and rookies. Look for one premium buyback card in every box. One. But you're going to find one-of-ones, RPAs, Logomans, tag, patches, multi-autos, BGS Black Labels, PSA 10s, cards with a population of one and more. All 30 NBA teams are represented. And as to be expected, this is a product designed for group breakers. So it'll be interesting to see some of the cards getting pulled out of here. A lot of Jordans, a lot of LeBrons. Yeah. You just drool over some of these, including, imagine buying into a break and pulling a graded Jordan rookie. I mean, that'd just be unbelievable.
Yeah, no, this is one of those live vicariously through the break video set.
Yep.
They get some really, really cool stuff out of here.
Absolutely.
And yet those black labels are just, that's one of those holy grail things. PSA 10s, yeah.
Unbelievable.
A lot of fun.
So that is Super Break Basketball.
Super Break Basketball. Let's stay on Friday again. Leaf Metal Draft Football. We're getting excited for the Leaf.
Draft is coming.
The draft is coming. NFL free agency is going on right now. So we're getting a little... They don't call it the hot stove. But that's an MLB thing. What do they call the offseason in the NFL?
I don't know what they call it.
The offseason.
For Bears fans, they call it hope and pray.
Well, same with Vikings fans. So we're in the same division, and we're... looking at the two bottom spots in that division. Well, the Vikings can come back. So, five on-card autographs in this set. Of all the big guys you should be looking for in the draft, we got Deshaun Watson. We've got... Christian McCaffrey from... He's the Stanford guy, right?
Yep,
the running back from there. Dalvin Cook from somewhere. I did not follow college football at all this year, but... I can get excited for my team in the draft. I'm definitely going to be looking for their Leaf Metal Draft autographs once the draft completes. I believe it's 49 days away. I think yesterday. That was going to be on this day in history. Or excuse me, something like that. Never mind.
That sounds about right. One of the things I like about Leaf Metal Draft is I'm a Notre Dame fan. I'm a Notre Dame collector. Upper Deck doesn't produce... Upper Deck holds the license for Notre Dame, so I can't get any Notre Dame football cards in Panini collegiate licensed products.
Oh.
Upper Deck doesn't produce a Notre Dame set every year. The last one was in, 2013. But here's the good thing. Notre Dame doesn't have a logo on their helmet. They just wear a gold helmet.
Oh, that's right.
So I'm able to PC my guys from Notre Dame through Leaf Products, sans logo, and not care because they don't have one on their helmet. So,
yeah, that's nice.
Yep. There you go. So I always check the checklist and chase my guys from Notre Dame, including who one guy I know is on the checklist for this product because I wrote the bio for it on the card back, Deshaun Kaiser. So,
oh, there you go.
I'll be looking.
And then there's flashback autographs. What is this? 2016 style autographs for players who could choose to stay in school last season in preparation for the 2017 draft. So,
yeah, that must be guys like they had like on the checklist last year and then didn't.
They went back to school,
but now I think they're going to put those in.
Here they are. Great.
So that releases next week. So awesome.
Yeah, next Friday.
But that's not the only, if you needed more draft pick products, it is that season. I mean, we had Sage this week, which we're also going to get to take a look at. I talked to the gentleman over there, Chris Stratton and Tom Geideman, the owners. They're going to hook us up with a box of draft Sage Hit Premier Low Series football card. That's got 15 autographs in every box, and we're going to give some of those away in a couple weeks. But next week, 2017 Panini Elite Draft Picks football comes out next Wednesday. Five autograph cards, four parallels, five inserts, 30 base cards, 30 draft picks in every box. 2017 opens up with the Panini Elite draft picks, the initial foray into the collegiate football ranks for this year. An extensive checklist loaded with rookies that'll be featured in the 2017 draft, including autograph versions ranging from 99 to 1. Lots of familiar insert sets that people like. Passing the Torch, College Ties, Alma Mater, including College and Pro Football Hall of Famers, veterans in their college uniforms. Chase the hottest rookies from the 2017 NFL Draft in Panini Elite Draft Picks Collegiate Football Cards from Panini next Wednesday.
Well, we're going to move. Let's see, what day are we on? We're on Wednesday again.
We've had every sport so far. We got some hockey now, right?
We got hockey with 2016-17 Fleer Showcase hockey cards from Upper Deck. This is them using the Fleer brand, which I think they do a great job
with.
Every box has an autograph card, four Metal Universe cards, four Flair row cards, card number to 150 or less. More number cards, additional insert. This is a loaded box, this Fleer Showcase. There's a lot going on. Wow. And so it's 2016-17 players using that fun old Fleer design to, what was the copy? I know I wrote a tweet about it.
If you're a fan of 90s inserts.
That's it. Those 90s inserts.
See, I pay attention.
Yep. They're great. It reminds me of collecting in the 90s when I was a youngster.
Absolutely.
And so there's a ton of them per box. I was a fan of when I believe it was the first time they used the Fleer branding with the Fleer Retro.
Yep.
What year was that?
A few years 13, ago. 14? Yeah.
I thought that was a great set. I had a lot of fun collecting that and opening that product. And so.
And people are going to like this one this year even better because it's got a new lower box price.
Oh, boy.
Oh, and it's overtime promotion pack wave 2 eligible. So keep on working on your overtime GTS exclusive hockey cards from Upper Deck.
Purples numbered to 5, greens numbered to 10, blue to 50, red to 150.
Yep.
They've got 101s. It looks like a lot of fun. I'm excited to see what comes out of this set. The top rookies, what their parallels go for. The patches look great. Looks like a fun set.
Yeah, it's got a couple new features I wanted to point out too. Fleer Showcase EX17, an ode to the classic 96-97 Fleer insert, and EX2000. So that's going to be cool. And the complete checklist is available at GoGTS.net for that. It's been out for a couple weeks.
We've got it here. You will see it on social next week when it releases.
Cool. Not to be outdone, speaking of Leaf, again, they've got their Masked Men hockey card product coming out. Goalies are an interesting breed, and they warrant a product all to themselves. Leaf Masked Men hockey cards delivers three autographed or memorabilia cards and three Leaf metal cards in every box. Exciting new addition to Leaf trading card hockey portfolio, featuring hockey's all-time greatest goaltenders. Back in the day in the game, did a product called Between the Pipes. This is Leaf's take on that. Look for the vault of vintage memorabilia that Leaf has is unbelievable. So look for stack the pads, dual game use pad swatches, game use material and shutouts, signature goalies. And how about this? Goalies legacy six swatch cards, Vezina winners, goals against. How about Masked Men, the return of this historic insert featuring Leaf's patented metal technology with nine different color variations, jumbo monster size pad swatches, goalie graphs, and I mean, basically, name a goalie and they're probably on this list. Everybody from Patrick Waugh, Carey Price, Vladislav Tretiak, Lundqvist, the works. So if you,
a lot of guys from the past with those old school masks.
Absolutely. So that comes out next Friday.
Next Friday. And then we'll finish out the week next Friday with 2017 Panini World of Batman sticker collection.
Yeah.
That's right.
I'm excited about this.
We got some Batman. Comes includes a total of 192 stickers, including 48 specialty stickers, of which 24 are shiny foils. We got some shine with Batman. Comes with a full-color 32-page collector's album with a fold-out poster. Chronicles the Batman franchise from his earlier roots to the latest Batman vs. Superman feature film.
Yes.
So we're going to get Adam West. We're going to get Michael Keaton.
Yes.
We're going to get Christian Bale, Heath Ledger, the Nolan
George Clooney.
I think is what they call it. Oh, yeah, Clooney and Val Kilmer. I forgot about them. I just went straight from Michael Keaton.
That's all right. I think everybody forgot about them.
But yeah, and then we got the new stuff with Ben Affleck and what's his name? Henry Cavill?
Yeah.
And Gal Gadot?
I got to admit, I don't get too excited about sticker products that often. I'm excited for this one. This is actually one I will be collecting.
Oh, boy.
So
it's fun.
I'm looking forward to it.
And there's villains. There's everything from the everything from the Batman universe. I see this sell sheet right here. We've got a little Harley Quinn there.
Yep.
We've got, what was the name of the actor that played the original Robin? I know Adam West.
Burt Ward.
There you go, Burt Ward. We got them all.
Yep.
And then I see there's some shiny versions. It's fun. So if you like stickers, if you like shiny, if you like Batman.
I'm in. So that wraps up Hot in the Shop for the week. Lots of stuff. Something for everybody, no matter the sport or genre. And you can get a complete rundown of all of these products in detail next Monday in our weekly post, Hot in the Shop, as well. All right, cool. Next up, and I'll just kind of cue this up and Joe will roll it. As I mentioned yesterday or earlier at the top of the program, had the opportunity to talk with Panini's NFLPA extern. I don't know why they call it an extern, and I forgot to ask.
I had never heard the term until I saw the video.
Yeah, so
interesting.
They've always called it that. I don't know what, but this gives people the players an opportunity to think about life after football and work in different capacities, usually in some sort of sports function. I know Fanatics Authentic had a program with a bunch of people, saw the stuff on social media last week. And it takes place this time of the year. And they had Valerian Ume Izuake, the center for the Pittsburgh Steelers. And I did my absolute best to pronounce his name, and he didn't correct me or get upset, so I must have done all right. And so we're gonna
you did good.
We're gonna take a look at what he had to say about working at Panini for a few weeks. In just a minute here. Joining us for a live look in at the Panini NFLPA externship program. We're pleased to be joined by center for the Pittsburgh Steelers, Valerian Ume Izuake. Valerian, thanks for taking some time to join us today.
Thanks for having me. It's my pleasure.
So, you've wrapped up, 2 weeks now at Panini America. First off, give us a little of an idea of what the NFLPA externship is all about and what its goals are.
It's basically a 3-week, course kind of, experience that you get with any company that, you know, wants to bring in a player. And you spend, 3 weeks with them and you get to see, basically a job from a different perspective, since we're always on the field constantly. We never really get to think about football, life after football. So this gives us a chance to see jobs and get an experience outside of football.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, your goal is to play ball for as long as you can. But you know, at some point that career ends and time to do something else. Now, I know you went to school at New Mexico. What did you study while you were at New Mexico?
I studied public health.
What was one of the things that most surprised you?
The biggest thing that surprised me was the production side of things. I never knew what exactly went into trading cards. You know, as a player, you see the card, you know, you open a wrap and, hey, I got a card, and so be it. But once you know exactly what goes into creating that card, is unbelievable. So the production of the cards and also the creation of the cards and the different color substrates that are used just to make the card shine, it's unbelievable. So that's the biggest thing for me.
Now, were you able to get a look at the game used memorabilia vault that they go into to make some of these cards?
I did. That's one thing. That's the cool thing about Panini America. They basically have had me at a personal level. They've shown me everything. I've been able to go to the memorabilia vault, and also I've been able to go to the production site where Panini America produced their cars and their products, and I've been able to see everything behind the scene and get the ins and outs of everything, and it's been really cool.
Awesome. Now, playing for the Steelers, obviously you're a key guy for Mr. Ben Roethlisberger under center. Did you get a chance to see any of his memorabilia or cards being made?
Oh, man, he's everywhere, man. he's everywhere. It's just, you know, it's cool just to, you know, hey, you know, I play with that guy. We actually opened some cards earlier today of the box. That's him right here, if you can see it. But it's pretty cool. I see him, Le'Veon, AB everywhere, and I think that's pretty neat.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. Before we started recording, you told me that you were getting to help and in the Father's Day promotion set. That's always a big hit with collectors. Can you provide us any details, or is all that still under tight wraps?
You know, I'll throw some things out there, you know. So we're gonna do it a little different this year. So we have a phrase that me, Tracy, and also Scott came up with is shine a light on them. Meaning that, you know, offensive linemen, we get shine a light on them. As an offensive lineman, you know, we're the unsung heroes. We don't get the spotlight. We do all the dirty work, and that's it. So I decided this year for the set of 15 cars to pick nothing but offensive linemen. The best players that that are in the league right now, I decided to put them in there. And I think it'll be a pretty cool thing for collectors and, you know, for them to be able to see a different side of things, and also to be able to put a spotlight on those guys that work hard every single day, that play in the trenches.
I love it. I am a big proponent of those guys. Growing up watching football with my dad, he was always one to point out that the big play wasn't possible without this guy right here. And growing up in Chicago, I got to watch Walter Payton run, and his post-game comments were always, you know, the line first, and he was always handing the ball off after a touchdown to the offensive lineman. So I can truly appreciate that. That's awesome. That's going to be a great addition to this year's set.
Exactly, and I appreciate that you appreciate that because, hey, we need some love too, right?
Absolutely. I came from a pretty well-grounded family, and my dad played some ball in high school, and he taught me the right way. He said, don't you ever, ever forget who's making the plays for real. So that's really cool. As the externship, I always want to say internship, but as the externship program winds down, what are some things that you might want to do life after football? Is this, you know, is being involved in the sports card side of things maybe one of them?
You know something? When I first came here, I didn't know what to expect. I knew Panini was a huge licensing group that were partnered with the NFL. I knew that. But I never really, you know, knew exactly what, you know, went in, transpired with them. So I think this is something I could do after I'm done playing. It's a fun environment. It's a great environment. The atmosphere is great. It's teamwork, and you know, if you're playing football, being able to translate teamwork into the workforce, I think that'll be a great transition trait for me. So I think I could be in the collectible world once I'm
very
done playing.
Cool. Now, I assume that you are in this Shine a Light on It set for the Father's Day set.
Yes. Most definitely.
Did they have you sign any cards for it?
I have yet to sign a card, but they did make me a card. I don't know. It's still in the wraps of what exactly is going to happen with that. I don't know if it's going to be auto cards or not, but I know for sure I will be in that set.
Awesome. Very cool. Well, listen, all the best to you coming up in your future endeavors. I know you're busy there trying to wrap things up, so I don't want to steal too much of your time, but thanks for talking with us. Our audience is going to love this. So it sounds like there's going to be a brand new insert set to be found in Father's Day pack promotions. Shine a light on them. I like
it. Shine a light on them.
Yeah.
It's fun. Well,
the unsung heroes playing in the trenches. One of the things I did when I found out that I was going to be talking to this young man was I went to see if he had any football cards because, you know, he's a center. Offensive linemen don't always have football cards, and sure enough, he didn't. But you could tell just how excited he was to find out that he's going to have one. So look for those in the cool Father's Day pack promotion. Now it's time for a little thing we like to call Toy Focus. We do a little crossover when we got some sports toys to talk about. And new coming out this year in July will be from McFarlane, the maker of the old Sports Picks brand, EA Sports Madden NFL 18 Ultimate Team Series 1. And in addition to an absolutely fantastic roster of players, which we'll detail here in a minute, key for this year is all the players are going to be featured in their Color Rush uniforms, which were worn in a select NFL Thursday Night Football game. So that's pretty cool. This year we've got Larry Fitzgerald, AJ Green, Russell Wilson, Carson Wentz, Melvin Gordon of the Los Angeles Chargers. That's going to take a while to get used to. Ooh. And don't tell Bree. And Von Miller of the Denver Broncos. I know Tracy Hackler is going to be happy about that. And as you can see in the pictures, they've got their Color Rush uniforms on. There will be alternates to chase for three of these figures. Carson Wentz is going to have a teal jersey and white pants. Larry Fitzgerald will have a red jersey and white pants.
AJ Green has an all-black
uniform. Yeah, the all-black uniform. So. That's what I was looking for. Thank you for the Cincinnati Bengals. So these orders are due from retailers coming up on these pretty soon, actually, but they will make their way to store shelves for collectors this July. So look for them soon. Check out the full blog post on GoGTS.net with Image Gallery. And we'll have to try to get our hands on a couple of these, do a little unboxing, because... You know, the Color Rush
uniforms look really...
Yeah, they do.
It's what it is. Color Rush. Tons of color. Yep. They're fun.
Absolutely.
I mean, say what you want about Thursday Night Football. I guess I'm not... we're doing this show on Thursday nights, folks. We don't watch the Thursday night game. But whether or not it's a good product is another debate. But the Color Rush, I like the Color Rush. I was always a fan of alternate jerseys. I get it. They're trying to sell jerseys. That's fine. They're fun.
Yeah, and if you're into Color Rush, you should do a search on GoGTS.net for Rydell's line of Color Rush helmets that are coming out this year. Brand new, including minis. So if you're an autograph collector, you have an opportunity to get some of your favorite players on the mini Color Rush helmets. That's pretty cool as well. All right.
Yes. Let's... Toy Focus.
That is Toy Focus. Now it's time. I don't know. Should we? You know, we've been talking so much about product. I feel like maybe we should look at some product. What do you think? Yep.
See what it looks like outside the pack.
Yeah,
okay.
We're okay.
We'll do that from time to time on this show.
So we'll take a look at some live box breaks here. Courtesy of Panini America. We had these queued up for last week. But we're going to do it this week. We're going to look at Panini Plates and Patches first, and then Donruss Racing. And I heard from Panini that Plates and Patches is sold out. Breakers have been going crazy over this product, so hopefully we can pull a couple booms tonight.
Yeah. I've been seeing it like crazy on the GoGTS Live Twitter feed. A lot of hits are being posted. So I'm excited. I got my little sniping tool up.
You're ready to take a screenshot.
Yep.
And as,
let's see this set.
As you know, when we do our live box breaks, we give away the big hits. Like to win with GTS. So what you need to do is you need to pay attention to the pinned tweets that James will tell you are activated, and you need to be in the chat room with us at the end of the show. Once the box breaks are concluded, this will be our last segment for tonight, to claim your prize if you're chosen at random to win.
I do want to say something, since it's all me tonight. Usually I'm helping Ivan when he does these, and I usually monitor live stream. He monitors Facebook. Facebook isn't it's tough to go between both. So I'm just looking at live stream right now. So what I'll do is I will take a your Joe's on Facebook. He can watch Facebook. I will watch live stream, and we'll get you.
All right.
So yeah, let's see it, Rob. That's all I had to say. The Panini plates and patches. It is a one pack per box product. So like Panini Limited or National Treasures, but not as expensive.
Yep. We've got one on-card signature or rookie per patch box. Autograph and a printing plate per box. So
and one prime memorabilia card. All
right. Let's check it out.
You're going to get an autograph. You're going to get memorabilia. You're going to get a printing plate. Let's see it. 2016 NFL. Dallas Cowboys had some good rookies, right?
A couple
of them. Boy, oh boy, rich get richer. Not really, no, they're good. They're very well run when it comes to GM, right? We'll see if they say that in the chat. Fly, Eagles, fly. Let's go. Jeff Gwynn, he wants those Eagles.
All right, here's plates and patches. Start off with a numbered parallel of Carl Joseph, number /50.
/50, that is of the base set. Carl Joseph, rookie, number 42, I'm going to guess defensive player.
Here's one of the up-and-coming running backs in the league, Jay Ajayi, number /99.
Jay Ajayi, if you play fantasy football, you heard about Jay Ajayi this year. He went on a nice little run.
All right. You know, some years you pull guys all the time. We had one year we pulled Kobe Fleener all the time. This year, our guy is Kenyon Drake. This is a nice four swatch. One of them is a patch, number /50.
Yep. Oh, nice. Pull a little closer a little bit for me. Just trying to get it in focus.
Hold on
folks.
One second. Let me see.
Get that patch.
Let me see
it's
if
all
I
right.
can help with that.
Yeah. Kenyon Drake. Up. Oh. Whoops. Got it.
All right.
Sharp. Got a nice little patch there.
And our autograph. On card, number /99, Jordan Matthews.
Oh, boy. There you go. From the Philadelphia Eagles. On card. Looks like he's got his initials and a number. Shiny. That's why we're not getting it in focus, but it looks nice.
And we've got a black printing plate, one of one, of Keenan Reynolds.
The Baltimore Ravens. They got that.
That's cool.
Decently in focus.
All right, not bad. Not bad. But guess what? I got another box.
Oh, boy. Look at that. Not one, but two. Fly, Eagles, fly, man. Jeff Gwynn, he said it, and we got an Eagle. That's pretty good. I'm looking for you in the chat, Jeff Gwynn. No way, very nice. Yeah, there it is. Exciting. I will not be putting my finger on the scale for you to win, Jeff Gwynn. That'd be wrong.
Oh, a little old school, Steve Largent.
Oh, boy.
I like the black and white photography.
Yeah, I was going to say black and white. That's cool.
Number /50. And base card of, might have heard of him, number /99, Drew Brees.
There he is.
And we've got a... autograph of Greg Olson. number 99.
Hey, another good veteran. Veteran pass catcher.
I wish the Bears should have never gotten rid of him. This was one of the stupid moves that they did to, quote, build around Jay Cutler, who they released today.
Did they trade him, or did they just let him go in
free
agency?
They just let him go.
Oh, boy.
Oh, I like this.
Oh,
Magenta
boy.
Played one-on-one of Mike Ditka.
Oh, hey, look at that.
Cool.
Oh, there he is.
That's cool.
The uniform.
Boom!
Nice little screenshot of that. That was the boom.
No, here's the boom. Look at the size of this patch of Will Fuller, rookie for the Houston Texans, numbered to 50.
Wow, look at that. And I got a good clean shot of it, Rob. Look at that.
That's nice.
Big old piece of jersey.
That's nice. All right, so
and he had a good rookie season.
Let's give away the Will Fuller tonight, and
Will Fuller,
the Greg Olson.
I'm gonna need another shot of Greg in focus. Bring him closer a little bit.
Hold on 1 second.
I got an okay one. I got an okay one. You guys see it. It's good.
All right. Plates and patches.
Will Fuller.
Oh, look at that.
Greg Olson.
I got another box.
Oh, my gosh, Rob. More. This is wild. This is just wild.
A trifecta of plates and patches.
Oh, my gosh. A third box is right, Jason.
All right, our parallel. Jared Goff, green parallel, number to 25.
There you go, rookie.
And Trevor Siemian, number to 99.
Quarterbacks. Is this a quarterback box, Rob?
Might be.
2 for 2. Are we going to see Dak Prescott? Carson Wentz?
You may know this guy.
Sure. Moritz Boringer.
Number to 50.
Although
two of those swatches are a patch.
He never saw any NFL action. I believe he was on the practice squad. I don't know if he's still there. Rooting for him, though. German. Not that I have any German in my blood.
Black 101 fun. Printing plate of Kendall Fuller.
Fuller. Kendall.
Boom! There it is. The patch auto on card number to 50 of Dak Prescott.
Gosh, look at this. One number off. Is that 05?
Yep.
One number off. We used to call that the Card Shark Special.
Last box mojo.
Wow. Yep.
Let's see if we can get a really good
picture. Yeah, we need a clean one. Oh, boy. This is what you want to hit, right? This and Ezekiel. It was a quarterback box. Look at that. Got it. Yeah. Fantastic. Boy.
Woo! Way to finish strong, Rob.
Yeah. way to have that box be the final one.
Oh, good stuff.
Yeah.
Good stuff. I'm going to start opening this 24-pack box of Donruss Racing and show lots of the cards because there's great stuff in here. But, James, you tell people what they got to do to win. Obviously, we're going to give the deck away in addition to the Greg Olson and the Will Fuller.
Deck, Greg Olson, Will Fuller.
All these other cards will go out in one of our... I want to say at this point, world famous monthly prize packs.
Yes. Oh my gosh. They're great. They're loaded. Everything that, I mean, we pull here that doesn't go out that next week to the fans watching live goes into that pile. So what's going into that pile? Three printing plates?
Yep.
Some patchet? Yeah, it's going to be pretty nice. Okay, so these images have been attached to a tweet. I'm going to write a tweet right now, folks. And then I'm going to pin it to the GoGTS Live Twitter page. I will announce that it is pinned, and you can retweet it.
All right.
You guys watch and know what's happening, how it works.
We got 24 packs a box, 10 carts a pack. We don't always open 24-pack boxes, but NASCAR from Panini is definitely a product worth opening on air in its entirety. So let's check it out. We've got Ryan Newman's car. Champ, Jimmy Johnson. Good looking cards. Super affordable at like 60, 65 bucks a box. Matt Kenseth.
Matt Kenseth from Wisconsin.
Reagan Smith.
Tweet posted. Tweet pin.
Insert of Rusty Wallace, numbered to 99, Classics.
That was a shiny one.
That was. The Mayor, Jeff Burton.
Jeff Burton, Lowe's. Oh, no. Never mind. I was watching the wrong screen. Jeff Burton, Ford.
Very cool. Interesting.
Landscape.
Checking the gloss. Can't tell if there's some gloss variations in here. That one seemed way more glossy than this one. There must be. I'll have to do a little research into that.
There's Dak. Somebody posted a nice little Dak gif.
Gentleman Ned Jarrett, old school.
Racing through the years. This is fun.
Jimmy Johnson. It's such an American sport. I mean, this started on the back roads of moonshine country. It's just
right?
Awesome,
yeah.
You know?
When did NASCAR first come about? I guess I remember it as a kid.
30s,
the old
40s.
Bright colored logos. Okay, so wow.
Yeah. Tony Stewart.
There he is, mobile.
No longer a driver, but an owner.
Jimmy Johns.
Brad Keselowski.
Oh, yeah, the Miller Lite guy. I know him by their sponsor.
That's a good thing.
Yeah. They like that.
Most overrated driver on the planet, Danica Patrick.
Oh, boy.
Hey, I'm a fan. I am. I just wish she would have stayed in IndyCar, and I wish she'd win once in a while. This is one of
it's
the...
like Tim Tebow.
This is one of...
She's like the Tim Tebow racer.
This is one of the, like, 80... This is like one of the throwback variations, Jimmy Johnson.
Oh, okay.
Danny Hamlin, Matt Kenseth.
Kenseth from Wisconsin. There's a NASCAR racer from my hometown. Now I need to look it up. No, that's
Ricky
fun, though.
Cravens from Maine. That's up in your neck of the woods, yeah, Joe. Bobby Labonte, parallel, number to 200. Kyle Busch.
Mobile resident.
A lot of people like this guy.
Yep, heard of him.
The M&M car.
Skittles. Mars.
You know who's a punk? I'm not a big fan of Joey Logano, and I'm not a fan at all of Kevin Harvick. Really? Really? We just heard from our producer that Kevin Harvick's wife used to work for Upper Deck. This is a parallel variation gold of David Reagan, numbered to 499. See the gold script.
Yeah. Harry Miller, commonly called Harry, was an American race car designer and builder who was most active in the 1920s and 30s. Griffith Borgeson called him the greatest creative figure in the history of the American racing car from my hometown, Menominee, Wisconsin.
We haven't come across Dick Trickle yet. Cousin Carl, Carl Edwards, retired. I think he dated Danica Patrick for a while, didn't he? Elliot Sadler, Ryan Newman. Still looking for our first hit. There's three of them.
Three per box, and I had the entry up. You get one autograph card, two memorabilia.
Denny Hamlin. There he is. The jerk. Kevin Harvick.
Ooh.
He just looks like a punk, doesn't he? Trackmasters. Jimmy Johnson, numbered to 999.
Tuna from Jimmy.
It's a cracked ice parallel.
Ooh. Cracked ice.
There he is, Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Blue colors. I was associated with red. No, what was his red agree. Sponsor?
Red and black, right?
Yeah. Yep. He still win races, Dale Jr.? Or is he done? Sure, good. Good for him. What a career.
Yep, just enough to keep his fans interested. Race Kings, Tony Stewart.
Huh. Oh, there he is.
There's the lovely Danica Patrick.
Ooh.
Yeah, who is her sponsor? Nature's Bake. So what, weed?
Oh, Goodyear?
Danica Patrick is sponsored by the marijuana. That's a
cash payment only. Yeah, cash only business.
Craig Biffle, Martin Truex Jr., Harvick. Oh, boom! Dakota Armstrong, number to 25. Nice. Oh, wow. Nice signature.
I've never heard of him, but to 25, he's a young up-and-comer. Look at him. He's a youngster. God, well, how old is that kid? 20?
That's something worth holding on to.
Yeah. Nice.
Might look back one day.
Nice little autograph there.
We knew him when. Rob pulled him out of a box. Boy. Donruss, 2017.
We knew him, and then he went off and... What is it, the Sprint Cup? Is that the one you want to win?
Is it still called the Sprint Cup, though? No, it's the Monster Energy, right?
Sprint Cup sounds better. Better brand. Sprint, you can
hear it. I mentioned to Panini that I'd be okay with a subset of Monster Energy Girl cards.
Oh, they have nice looking ladies.
Ryan Newman.
Cat.
Mark Martin, classic.
There you go. I remember that name. Oh, a backwards card. Oh, okay. So it's not. I see backwards and I think,
So what do people think? You guys like the look of this stuff? I think it's a pretty good looking product.
They like the autograph. Very nice autograph. It's fun. It's a woman taking
company. This is one of my guys right here, Chase Elliott. $4.99, and I'll tell you why he's one of my guys. I had an opportunity to meet him at the Panini VIP party.
Cool.
As genuine and down and earth to guy you'll ever meet. I'm going to talk about young drivers. Who is this guy? William Byron?
Oh, wow. Yeah, youngster.
In the Camping World Truck Series. Oh, so he races against the young gentleman we interviewed. Oh, when was that? End of the year last year?
So this is all racing, not just NASCAR. You got the truck series. Or is that NASCAR
underneath
the NASCAR umbrella?
NASCAR umbrella. Race Kings, Bobby Labonte.
So this is a NASCAR
product. It's got people from the truck series and then Xfinity. Xfinity's right under.
So that's why racing. Yep. Okay.
The main event. Here's a photo variation. Or no, this is Dale's base card. The other one was one of the throwback inserts. Gosh, look at this guy. Look how young they are. Yeah, see up here it says Xfinity Series. Eric Jones.
Byron races for Kyle Busch Motorsports. From the chat. Thank you, Donnie Springfield.
Look at champ Jimmy Johnson.
There he is. Driven around the track once or twice.
Xfinity Series.
Ooh, a big old Bass Pro Shops logo. See, that's what's great about this. All the logo patches.
Race Kings. Carl Edwards. I like that. Show the driver and the car.
Yeah.
Two memorabilia cards still defined. I got it.
NASCAR is not my thing, but the cards are cool. Ron Ward in the live stream. I agree. It's not really my thing, but I've had some of the most fun watching you open the NASCAR sets from Panini. They've been great.
National Treasures was great.
This has been a lot of fun. that was
not exactly fair.
Yeah. But this is a fun little rip.
Rookie of Garrett Smithley. Look at him. He is 11 years old.
Okay, look at this kid.
He's 11.
Yeah, and he's racing NASCAR. Gosh. Yeah, he looks 14. He looks like Lights, Camera, Jackson, if you've ever heard of him. He's in college. He's a little older. Shout out Lights, Camera, Jackson.
Oh, there's a memory.
Yeah, I agree. People are saying in the chat that Yuck looks so young. Oh, you can feel it. It's one of these. Yep.
What? Say that again, Joe. Say that again.
At GoJPG is my Twitter handle. People are asking for it. Sorry, I'm not in Facebook. Five letters. GoJPG. I don't tweet a ton, but when I do. What was my last tweet?
Oh, I like this pole position, Jimmy Johnson. Thank you, Ben Rhodes.
There you go.
Oh, there we go. Rubber relics of the jerk.
Here we go.
Kevin Harvick.
The jerk. Oh, that's right. You don't like him. I thought that.
Should I keep my personal biases? NASCAR nickname. Out of the break? No, no. It's really.
No, it's fun. It's fun. I like it.
Do like the relics from NASCAR race. I mean, you can get everything from helmets to caps to tires to sheet metal. This is a rubber relic tire race used. There she is again. Every box guarantees four Danica Patrick.
Danica? Yeah, we've seen a couple of those. And that's the guy from last week had some doubles in a box he ripped. He ripped that today on Twitter. You're going to get some cards to trade.
Race. Trevor Bayne.
Race Kings. Well, I've never heard of him. That's a shiny card. Is it shiny or is it just white and bright?
Yeah, it's a little white. And Dale Earnhardt Jr. Look back at a couple of his rides.
That's no red. Green card. Oh, that's right. He was Mountain Dew for a bit. I do remember that. I remember seeing
that. Yeah, he had those great ads. Mountain Dew.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, let's get a random fact from the producer, Joe Fallon. Dale Sr. wouldn't allow
cards
on his cards. Hmm. Upper Deck had an insert that had a die-cut dollar sign, and Dale Sr. would not be part of the set because he doesn't want green on his cards. Didn't want green on his cards. Yeah, that is an obscure little tidbit. I like those little tidbits.
Yeah, wow. Good for him. Keeping that brand true. He understood branding. What was his big sponsor?
Good Wrench.
People loved Dale Earnhardt growing up, too. Good Wrench, I'd say. Yeah, I've never seen those Good Wrench shirts around school.
Fred Lorenzen.
2015 inductee.
Starting out as a mechanic for Holman Moody team in 1960, Lorenzen was promoted to lead driver by the end of the year and went on to win 26 races during a 12-year NASCAR Sprint Cup Series career. An extremely popular figure who went by the nickname the Golden Boy. Yep.
The Golden Boy.
An insert of Danica Patrick. This one numbered to 499. It's actually a good-looking picture.
Where is the... Oh, yeah. Look at that. Those are the aviators. Where is the NASCAR Hall of Fame?
My guess would be I would say North Carolina.
Florida?
My guess.
Yeah. Looking it up now, folks. Charlotte, North Carolina.
Green is taboo.
Oh, is it?
Except for the flag.
Oh. Dale just... disregarded that. This is Mountain Dew. They still drink milk at the end of races? That thing?
Ned Jarrett, numbered to 299.
These old cars, the old ones are a lot of fun.
That was safety equipment.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Kyle Busch.
Yeah, a lot of cards in this set. A lot of cards in this box. You get a fun rip. What's the base set?
Fantastic.
Let's see here.
Like I said, you're guaranteed bunch of Danica Patrick cards, the speed insert. I like this. I like the fact, I like it when you can see the car and the person. Casey Kane.
Well, it doesn't say how many cards in the base set.
It would in the checklist, right?
Oh, well, we got a checklist here. Yeah, here, it's I'm going to put in the PDF now.
I had to guess. I'd say 300 cards.
Yeah. These are blue foil.
Insert we haven't seen. Oh! The Elite Series. Richard Petty. Number 10. $4.99.
Oh, look at that. That's fun.
I got to see him race.
He's got autographs in the set. And if they look like the mock-ups, it's a pretty autograph. Oh, yep, I know that name. Sprint Nextel, that's it. That's the little thing, Nextel. Boom, what a run. We're still getting retweets on the pinned tweet. If you're just joining us, we've got a pinned tweet on our Twitter profile, at GoGTSLive. Boom, what a run of 2016 Panini America Plates and Patches NFL. Join us live for a chance to
cut
win
to the chase, these Jimmy Johnson, hits. 2016.
Okay, that's fun. So that's an insert set with like the winning photo. That's fun.
And, whoa, boom, Brad Keselowski, Rubber Relics, dual number to 10. And look at those.
Wow.
I mean,
look at this.
The blue and the yellow right off of the Goodyear on the sidewalls.
Gosh. Wow.
Oh.
You have to bring it closer. Let's get a little. Yeah, wow. That's a fun card.
10.
Number to what again? 10. Yeah. I thought it was low. Dual rubber.
Hold on one second.
I'm going to have to go with this. It's not the cleanest. There you go. Okay.
That's about the best right there. That's definitely the one we're giving away.
His name. Yeah. I got a nice shot of it.
All right. You tell them what they got to do as we wrap this up. You can start announcing some winners for those other ones while I open the last two packs.
Okay, so folks, we have. Yep, we're still getting a few retweets on our plates and patches. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do the same. We're just doing the to 10. Great. So we got one more hit to give away. It is from that box of 2017 Donruss Racing. It is the Brad Keselowski to 10 rubber. I am putting that picture in a tweet right now. This is play-by-play, folks.
You're doing great, James. Much appreciated.
Yeah, good. Thank you, Rob. Thank you, Rob. Well, Ivan Lundgren will be back.
We are, thank you for mentioning. We are actually off next week, unfortunately. Our producer, our faithless producer, Joe Fallon, has to travel. But we will be back the last 2 weeks of the month. We've seen a couple of inserts we haven't seen before in these last two packs. Top tier.
Whoops. They wanted to put two photos in. We've had the same link all night. That's great. We've got a new setup, folks. It's doing well. Donruss Racing.
That was a look at Donruss.
Got to tag Panini America.
So.
Panini America has been, they've been great to us.
Please.
Don't forget to thank them on Twitter. We like it when you think. They like it here and thank you. For all the product they send us here. Boy, oh boy,
yeah,
what
we
a
ended
night.
Up doing good. We got a Will
Rob
Fuller jumbo
nice
patch. We got a Greg Olson on card, numbered to 99. We got a Dak Prescott patch on card, blue parallel, numbered to 50. and a Brad Keselowski dual race used tire swatch numbered 210. Go GTS Live, home of the boom. The
racing.
GTS.
Yep. Go GTS Live right now on Twitter. It is pinned. The racing. The racing tweet is pinned. And so I'm just going to take a quick second, draw our football winners. And Rob, if you need to do some housekeeping.
Just to draw now's some the time attention to, do it. To some things on the blog. Is that up wrappers here. If you stay tuned for a post coming up about series from Import Dragons, the 2.5-inch NHL figure line, which combines a tabletop game and a digital app. Super cool, innovative product. The figures are blind wrapped. You can buy a three-figure starter pack with the dice and tabletop mat, and then individual blind wrap figures out of a gravity feed box. All the figures come with a card with a scratch-off code that then can be entered into the app. You can compete online with friends or against other league members for real prizes. So not only do you have the figures, which are collectible in and of themselves, the figures also then have some of the players have chase variants in uncommon and rare. Then you can play a tabletop game and play a digital online app. So we'll have all the information about that coming from Imports Dragon for you here shortly. Also, we've got the new checklist coming up soon in a feature article about Imports Dragon's new MLB figure line, the Series 4 2017 MLB season. It's robust, a lot of great players in it. So stay tuned to the blog, gogts.net, for that. And I've got an interview, a written interview, that goes into a bit more detail with Mr. Ume Iziaku, that from Kelsey Schroyer.
It's a tough one.
Who did an interview with him via email that goes into, like I said, a bit more detail. That'll be up tomorrow. And the much-promised Panini Select Basketball checklist as well. So stay tuned to all of that.
Okay. So I've only drawn two so far, but we can start it off because we got a little bit of lag. So the first winner, the winner of the Will Fuller patch, is at Two Wicked Carl on Twitter. Carl the Entertainer. I feel like I saw you in live stream. Maybe not. But you won the Will Fuller. So say hi on live stream or Facebook. Joe's is watching Facebook. And so we have our next one. The winner of the Greg Olson autograph. Your name is Jeff Franklin, at Jeff Franklin 2678. So I'm going to write down your Twitter handle for reference later for the email I send to
all winners. Please email us at GoGTSLive at GoGTS.net. GoGTSLive at GoGTS.net with your name, mailing address, and the name you used in the chat room or Twitter.
And yep, your Twitter handle and everything. Because what I do is I send I'm going to send these names to Rob after the show, and then he can reference that when he gets the emails. So, there's old Dacky boy. I don't think anybody calls him that. Okay. Well,
It's a process, folks. It's a process. Just marvel
I mean,
luxury.
So
talk to me, Goose.
This guy's gonna like this because it says in his we now follow you, Mr. Brian Edmonds, at B Edmo Cards and UPC Dallas Cowboys.
So this went to the right winner.
This guy went to the right guy. His name Brian Edmonds. He is in Facebook. Brian Edmonds, you just took home a Dak rookie patch auto.
Congratulations.
50? Oh my. I saw it and I was like, it says PC Dallas Cowboys. It landed on him. It doesn't get any better than that, folks. Although Jeff Gwynn, sorry,
I've
didn't
seen
get you that.
Quite a few tire swatch cards in my time in the hobby. This is the first time I've ever seen them from the sidewalls to include Goodyear lettering. I think that's pretty darn cool.
I thought I didn't know that was.
I guess this would be considered
a
prime.
The tires wore down. Yeah, very prime, very prime. So, let's see. We don't want to sit here all night. The pinned tweet, it has 50 retweets. We had 66 on the deck. Let's wait just a second. I'm looking for Carl and Jeff Franklin. Have you seen them, Joe? Okay. So we might have a redraw. Folks, I gotta run through these the chat room on live stream. So if you did win and you're here, just shout from the rooftops.
Repeat the winners' names again. Besides the DAC, the other two, we're looking for
Carl the Entertainer at Two Wicked Carl, who follows us.
You should know what to do
on Twitter.
Got to be in the chat room to win.
Gotta be in those chat rooms. And then Jeff Franklin at J Franklin 2678. Again,
while you're doing that, I want to say thank you to two of our viewers and followers, Mike Estrich and Terry Deck. As you know, a couple weeks ago, I was at meetings at our corporate office and we didn't have a show. It happened to be. I was in meetings all day of National Hockey Card Day, unable to locate a hobby shop. Mike hooked me up with the American set, and Terry hooked me up with the Canadian set. Thank you very much. Both of them had Blackhawks in them, so you guys know I needed them. Really appreciate you hooking me up in that manner.
Okay. I'm drawing the NASCAR
right
now.
Here we go.
Okay. This is one of our... Donnie S., the Dingo Dad. And I know you're here because I saw
you on
Twitter.
The Dingo ain't your baby.
Just not too long ago. Yep, and we like Donnie S. because he interacts with those on this day in history tweets that I've been doing. So thank you, Donnie S., for doing that. And thank you for watching Go GTS Live. Donnie Springfield, there he is.
Perfect.
In live stream. All right. So we're still waiting on Carl, the Entertainer. Carl the Entertainer,
he
we
was
need you.
The Greg Olson.
We also need he was the Will Fuller patch. And then Jeff Franklin, he's the
Joe,
Greg Olson.
Joe, you see them at all? No.
Oh boy, so we might have to.
You guys didn't even need to stick around that long. Usually we do Brax breaks at the top of the hour and make you watch the whole show.
Yeah.
There's a method to our madness.
Right?
I mean, we're generous, but hey, gotta make a living here. All right, that's it. We're gonna redraw.
Okay.
We are going to redraw, so be sure to stay in the Facebook and live stream chat rooms, and we are going to redraw for both of these cards.
We are redrawing, folks. Let me take one more look. No, I don't see the names. Okay. So we had 16. Yeah, it's a rough one. Okay, off of all the numbers, so drew.
There was two of them, so I'm gonna. Batteries are replaced. But that's what I tell my kids though when they try to grab it. Like, I'm gonna waste the batteries. I'm gonna need it to be dead.
Okay, so we've got a new winner of the Will Fuller patch, Toledo Prep Pleasures Drew. I feel like he's won from us before, right? Toledo Pleasures
Say hi in
Drew.
whatever chat room you're watching in. So we see you.
Toledo Pleasures Drew. Okay, let me just write it down.
The first week in April, we will be at the industry summit, and we are looking to partner with Beckett Radio to do a some sort of dual show where we'll stream live on Facebook and also be part of their podcast. Stay tuned for more information about that. We'll be bringing you as much breaking content news as is revealed as the show goes along.
Okay, let's see. For the winner of, I feel like this guy wins all the time. Winner of the Greg Olson autograph,
He does
Michael
win all the time.
McManus.
Congratulations, Michael. I know
He wins. Michael
he's in there.
McManus. We know he's here.
He's in Facebook. Boom.
Yeah, okay. So McManus, there you go. Greg Olson.
So we just need
Gosh.
the Will Fuller still. Toledo Pleasures.
Nope. Toledo Pleasures. We're looking for you. Did you see him, Joe?
Say
No,
yes.
okay.
All right. How about random cards on Rob's desk while we wait?
Oh, fun.
Perfect game, Bowman. Carson Fuller on card auto from Bowman. Number to 199.
Cool.
Courtesy of Mike Estridge. How about it is unbelievable what day for the day with the cup cards go for on eBay. Here's one of Brent Seabrook. Again, courtesy of Mike Estridge. I bought this myself because I had an opportunity to interview him in 2010 at the first
Oh, cool.
Blackhawk Stanley Cup. Jordan Hendry, Letterman patch. All right, we're going to redraw again. We've ne we
All right, Toledo Pleasure. Sorry, even though I did see you retweet something, it says you retweeted something of ours 55 seconds ago. You must be on major lag. Okay, so we're redrawing. Okay. The winner,
Yep.
Will Fuller, right? Will Fuller, Jeff Moses, at PNNYWSE.
Random stuff on my desk.
Jeff.
I found this figure at a thrift store. It was in a badly beat up package. This is Felicity Shagwell. Heather Graham. From Austin Powers, the spy who shagged me for $3. So I salvaged. Cool. Yep.
He's here?
All right. So I salvaged what I could, great. Made this backdrop and base, and she even talks.
Oh, cool. Look at that.
You're a groovy
boy. Oh, does she say groovy baby?
I'm a groovy boy. Oh. But now that all the winners are announced and that's the random stuff on my desk, that's going to do it for this episode of Go GTS Live. Thank you very much to the asset and guest co-host, James Gale, our producer, Joe Fallon. Thank you to Panini America for providing product and hooking us up with that interview with Valerian. Wishing you a happy weekend of collecting. We are off next week. We'll be back the week after that, finishing off the month strong with two shows, then head to the industry summit. We'll be bringing you a bunch more content. I'm Rob Bertrand for Ivan Lovgren, who's not here. He will be back returning in 2 weeks when we do. Thank you and have a great weekend.
Bye.